Tech TV, experience educational television.
The College of Art and Built Environment graduated 913 students, of which 848 were undergraduates and 65 were postgraduates. The ceremony took place on Wednesday, 11th July 2018, at the Great Hall of KNUST. The graduation ceremony started with the arrival of the convocation and Vice Chancellor's procession. The best student of the College of Art and Built Environment gave a speech.
I am humbled and deem it a great honor to stand before you to deliver the speech this morning. Graduation brings to mind our past experiences and the excitement for the future. It is the day that marks the end of the chapter we began 4 years ago, as well as the beginning of a new one in our lives. There were days that some of us thought we could never make it to this day, but here we are, clad in our robes and caps. We are overwhelmed with joy. Look at how far the Lord has brought us. The feeling of triumph we are experiencing today did not come without a cost.
The provost of the college, Professor Joshua Ayakwa, gave a speech.
At this ceremony, the college is graduating 65 postgraduates and 848 undergraduate students from the Faculty of Art and the Faculty of Built Environment. Out of the undergraduate number, 649 are males and 199 are females, detailed as follows.
A contemporary artist, Ibrahim Mahama, motivated students with his enormous experiences and achievement.
It was also around the time when our department was experiencing a revolution under the leadership of Dr. Karikacha. And I think one of the things that struck us within that period was that within our history, as artists who were practicing and also going into the world, there was a tendency of just leaving school and then thinking about how to survive or how to make money. But a lot of these questions, most of the time, we never really quite understand the implications of these things and the choices that we make when we leave school. So one of the things that I remember that I actually learned and picked up from this university was actually developing a practice that would be a lot more sustainable and looking at it into the much distant future.
Graduates were honored with various degrees. Tech TV News spoke to the outgoing president of the college, Mr. Caleb Deborah.
I want to first of all thank God for how far he brought us as students, the whole college. Our parents have really done well. We also have to appreciate them, the support they gave us in all our endeavors. See, combining academics and politics hasn't been easy. From department president to college president, and still graduating the first class, hasn't been easy. But I say all glory be to God, and thank you to my parents, Mr. and Mrs. Samuel Deborah. With the awards, one thing I made it my core mandate is to serve the people, service before any other benefits. And so if you make it your core mandate that you serve the people no matter what, you don't want any other gain, you surely make it. And in the end, posterity will judge whatever you give out. And so in doing all my works, I never expected any awards, but God being so good, the whole university.
The best student of the college spoke to Tech TV News.
During the time that I was doing my thesis, we were supposed to come up with topics that are actually feasible, topics that we can actually implement them. But then we realized that others have done similar topics, that same, even though it's not the same, they've also done topics that if the findings from those thesis or project was to actually be brought to you, it will help not only the university but even our society and our nation at large. Yes, because with the topic that I did, it's something that GES can take up and then do it. So that is why I was suggesting that, and some of my colleagues also did topics that can also help the society, because the findings they came up with were really solid. So if the university would really take up student thesis or project, go through it, and then pick the 10 best works, and then utilize those findings, it will really make an impact.
Mr. Ibrahim Mahama, who was the motivational speaker, interacted with Tech TV News.
I think it's been very much well received, and it's also generated a lot of discussions.
Okay. people asking a lot of questions and want to know more about what it is, because it looks quite strange. But I think that's what we need. We need more strangeness for people to be able to at least reflect upon things that they are used to, which they somehow take for granted. Not really in exhibition sense, but if you're talking about this, the value of the work
the
in terms of its work, then this work will be worth millions. So it's more, the works I was talking about were special projects which you, as I produce as an artist,
okay,
which I sell to institutions, which the money I use in doing my independent projects. But like works like this, I cannot sell because I also have to keep it for the sake of posterity. So one day when we have institutions and other spaces, we can also keep these things as part of our archive and our own history.
Big TV, experience educational television.